component R in this scheme is in applied to more ways. So less filters have been investigated the role of argumentation motivated systems, which has two main applications, reasoning and communication. And something to say here is that we have a few approaches in the type of side of fine argumentation technique in motivated systems, so it is a kind of challenging problem to work on. But in argumentation-based reasoning, we have developed an argumentation-based reasoning mechanism inside an agent on a parallel language. The advantage of that is that we make transparent the way we implement agents and our approach is based on, so I should say, our approach is based on structural argumentation, which the professor was taught in the introduction in this morning, and in particular in the physical logic. So the basic idea here, agents are able to, based on the information they have, the knowledge available to them, they are able to construct arguments. And based on the structure of the argument, they are able to identify conflict information and attack with arguments. And at the end, given the set of arguments they are able to construct, they are able to evaluate them and define which arguments are stable or not. So here we can think about an agent dialoguing with itself. If an agent has a decision to make, it can construct an argument supporting that decision and arguments against those arguments is able to construct, and at the end of it has a simple conclusion, a safe term, and support the decision making to the action. And as I say, here we have implemented an approach that agent can construct arguments. So if an agent needs to communicate an argument, it has the argument supporting a particular conclusion, or maybe some mental attributes of the agent, for example, maybe or something like that. So, agents are able to construct arguments, and we just need to allow them to communicate those arguments. So, in order to allow that, we have implemented, we have identified the main performance activities, the main speed act, argumentation-based dialogues used from the literature, and we have defined formal semantics that speech for that performative in BDA agents, in agents based on BDI architecture. So basically what we say, what we make is to define the meaning of the communications based on the mental attributes of the agents. And of course, argumentation is not a simple message, the communication of simple message. We have a kind of trace. We have a kind of a number of messages that will means a dialogue. We have a dialogue, a number of messages will change. So we have also implemented some dialogue artifact that allow us to stop commitments that agents make in a dialogue. So if an agent making a self move and introduce an argument, the agent is committed to defend that information he's using in a particular. So after that, actually we had a practical argumentation framework to implement motivated systems that would take advantage of argumentation techniques in reasoning and communication. But our main issue here at that point was which arguments agents are going to use. And the answer for that is it depends on the application's needs. So when we are developing an application, we need to care about which kind of arguments the agent will use inside my application. If I'm going to implement a motivated application for a particular domain, I need to define which kind of argumentation schemes, which kind of patterns of arguments I'm going to use in that particular application. So our initial was how to define argumentation schemes in our framework. So that's what my research has talked about and in my PhD. And to represent argumentation schemes and motives in a logical formalism is something complicated because, for example, some authors have proposed to represent argumentation schemes using the feasible inference tools. For example, ASP framework, that is a well-known framework for argumentation. But in this kind of translation from argumentation scheme to a physical inference pool, we miss the critical questions. That is something implicit sometimes in the argument. So we have And we thought that is a bad idea because most of the frameworks in argumentation say that the support of an argument should be minimal to draw a particular conclusion. So that could be not effective for most of the argumentation frameworks we have in the future. And the second option is to share argumentation scheme with agents. So when agents use an argumentation scheme in communication, they receive in that argument that is an instance for an argumentation scheme, is able to identify which critical questions are related to that argument. So we thought that the best option is sharing argumentation schemes with agents, and we are proposing two alternatives for that. The first is an elimination of the organizational model. That's something more theoretical because organizational models for multi-agent systems are theoretical. So when we extend them to add something else, for example, argumentation schemes, the representation of argumentation schemes, we also, at the end, the work also is theoretical. And another option is a shared database, for example, Ontology. We can actually represent argumentation schemes on Ontology and share the agents. So here we have just an overview of the first idea to specify argumentation schemes in the multi-agent system specification organization. So here we have some interesting ideas that we can actually, for example, connect to the normative systems and define, for example, that a nurse is not going to use a critical question challenging the expertise of the doctor, for example. That is something interesting in terms of simulating or implementing multi-agent systems based on the organization part. And the other options, we can use Ontology artifacts. Actually, we have implemented Ontology artifacts that allow me actually instantiate in Ontology the multi-agent systems. So agents, we can define a global workspace and instantiate in Ontology represent our organization teams. In that workspace, our agents are able to know that. So, okay, I talked about how to represent the argumentation schemes in Ontology, so how that changed the things we have been doing until now. Well, we are proposing that now we don't have just the idea of to be able to construct arguments, but to construct a simple instance of arguments. So we have extended our previous approach that nation should be able to construct an argument, but also to make that argument a simple instance of the argument the scheme the argument is based on. So the agent not only needs to make the inference to construct an argument, but also answer possibly answer the critical question related to this. And after that, after to have a simple instance of an argumentation scheme, the agents can use that a simple instance to execute argumentation reasoning using other instances of other argumentation schemes or maybe from the same argumentation scheme. So that's just an overview that argumentation schemes actually are shared and the agents can use those argumentation schemes to reasoning and communication. But, and as examples of application, so the idea of our work is to have a practical framework in which argumentation schemes are the input of our framework. So the argument component, our framework is based on a particular script for argumentation schemes, and they are the input of the system. So when we want to develop a particular argumentation system application, we just define the argumentation schemes we are going to use in that application, and agents are able to instantiate them and use in our system. One example scenario, I will present this work in Roma, if you guys are going to say, please come down, I will give more details, is argumentation schemes for data access control. That's the challenging issue today because we are talking about different systems sharing information and how to implement data access control between these systems. Thinking about implementing this application using mobile systems. So we are proposing in this work the argumentation schemes for data access control, in which it's an input for our systems and we enable our interface agents to reason about data access control. So if the agent is able to construct a simple instance of that argumentation schemes, that means the agent is have a this framework, and when we look to it, we have some interest ideas that we can. We figure out that we could, for example, use NPMs in our framework. One of the benefits of sharing organization schemes, for example, is the idea of using NPMs, thinking about the logical representation we are using in our work. And using NPMs is something very interesting because imagine you guys use a software communicating like we humans do, like for meeting common knowledge. So FMS has this idea that is incomplete arguments in the common knowledge is omitted. So here we have an overview of this idea of FMS in our program. So we have argumentation schemes that are shared by agents, and also for some argumentation schemes, for example, the position to know that is seen like very expert opinion. We have some organization model that also is shared by agents inside the mobile systems. So the resulting argument in the larger representation should be something like the first argument here. And actually, you can omit the argumentation scheme, the representation of argumentation schemes, and the premise that are shared technology, for example, organization knowledge, and we have a short argument and the agents can communicate. And using just a reference to the argumentation schemes we are using to construct the argument, agents are able to have the same understanding of the intended argument. Well, some conclusions we have. We are construct,